how many times is it so that you feel disrespected, you feel that the other person has a rude or an inappropriate behavior towards you, you feel hurt, but you really are not able to do much about it. So today we are talking about a very important topic, which is how to command respect from people towards you. Now, we cannot control what others are doing, how others are behaving, but we can definitely control how others behave towards us. Or maybe a better way to put it across would be how we react to how others behave. So hello everyone, to my regular viewers and subscribers, thank you so much and welcome back. And to those of you who are new to the channel, I am Ghazala Zaidi and I help you in becoming a better version of you every single day. Human being is a social animal. We live in settings and spaces where we interact with so many people every day, with our family, with our friends, with our partners, with our co-workers and bosses in the workplace. And it is very important that in all these spaces, in all these settings, do not feel being disrespected or being hurt by someone. Now, how do you know that you have been disrespected? Is obviously your intuition, your gut will tell you that there is something wrong with this behavior, that it is inappropriate, it has hurt you, it is rude. And that is, I think, the best judge of it. Now, what can we do to command respect from people? I'll not ask you to go to people and tell them, respect me, respect me. No, you cannot do that. But you can definitely do some things at your end which can help you. The first and the most important being learning to say no. Yes, I know you have heard it 1,000 times before, but the importance of saying no can never be undermined. Because if you are a people pleaser, or if you are in a codependent relationship, or if you are always in a rescuer mode, you're always saying yes to people, you will not be able to command their respect. Because a person who says yes to everything generally ends up being taken for granted. The next important thing to understand, which is again, you have been like listening to it for ages, but it is extremely, extremely important. The fact that if you do not respect yourself, no one is going to respect you. So you have to start to respect yourself. If you have a low self-esteem or a low self-confidence, if you do not respect your own existence, if you do not respect what you are doing, you will never know whether other people are really respecting you or not, because you have not set those standards for yourself. If you work on yourself and you know your self-worth, you will not take bullshit from people, because you know what your worth is, and therefore you will be in a better position to command respect from others. The third point that I want to talk about is, see, relationships are give and take settings. Whether it is your co-worker or your partner or your friend or your family, it can be anyone. If you are just giving and giving in a relation, you will never be able to command respect in that relationship. Because if you're only investing in something without the other person investing in you, you will never really be important for the other person, because they are not putting out any effort to maintain this relationship. So you will never be that important for them, and they will never give you the respect that you deserve. I especially want to talk about this when it comes to new relationships. A lot of time it so happens that when we start dating someone, when we start getting into a new relationship, when we go to a new office and start talking to our new colleague, we kind of, without really even understanding the other person, we start giving just so that we are accepted. But this need for acknowledgement and validation only reduces your importance and thus your respect. Another very important aspect of learning to command respect from people is learning to set your own boundaries. Now, it is very important, because if you do not know your boundaries, that what is acceptable for you, what is not acceptable for you, then you will never know whether the other person is breaching them or not. Now, even more important than learning to set boundaries is to be able to enforce those boundaries. For example, I may set a boundary for myself in my head that I do not want someone to demean me for my physical appearance. But when someone does so, especially someone close, maybe your partner, your friend, when someone does so, you are not able to enforce it because you think that the other person will feel bad, or it may not be appropriate for you to say this thing, it might offend the other person. But no, what happens is that when you accept a behavior from someone, even if you felt bad about it and you stay silent, you're actually telling the other person that you're okay with that behavior, and they will continue to do so unless you tell them. Now, I'm not asking you to go and argue with them or fight with them, but you have to kind of tell them that, see, I cannot take this. And if they genuinely want to be in your life, they would definitely understand what you are trying to say and what your boundaries are, and they will respect you. If not, you are definitely better off without them. And the last thing that I want to talk about today is to learn how not to react to people but respond, and how to verbally communicate to people what you want. Now, this is very important. Let me explain it a little. So a lot of times it may happen that someone is really angry and they come to you and they start shouting at you and screaming at you and saying all kind of crap. And now if you do not know how to verbally communicate with them and not to emotionally react, you also start arguing with them, you also start getting angry, or you might feel very helpless and victimized in that particular situation. Now the way to come out of this is to be able to see this entire thing from a distance. Because what the other person is doing, that when they are venting out, they are basically taking out all their anger, all their negative feelings from themselves and transferring it to you. So now this person has started feeling relieved and relaxed, and you are drained. You get all that negative energy, all that anger, all that low vibration. Your job in such a situation is to understand that this person right now is in an emotional state in which he or she is not able to control his demeanor, his behavior. And I need to detach myself from this and tell this person very clearly that, see, right now you're not in control of what you're saying, what you're doing. So we better discuss it later when you can talk sensibly. So when you learn to disengage from a situation and be able to very clearly, articulately communicate with the other person that you're not going to take whatever they're saying, in whatever mood they are, you're not going to entangle with them, then definitely you will be in a much better position to defend your respect. So this is all for today. If you use any other ways of commanding your own self-respect, or if you feel that there are situations in your life where you could have used one of these techniques to command your self-respect, then definitely do let me know in the comment section below. Please do not forget to give this video a big fat thumbs up, share with your friends, and please subscribe to the channel. See you tomorrow. Toodles.